many libraries open as we possibly can. But I'll reiterate this, because of the cuts, we are going to be looking at more volunteers. It's our communities now, and I'm not being political here, but we've lost 150 million, we've got to lose 42 million this year, another 130 million by 2020. So the council will cease to exist by 2020. This council will cease to exist as we know it now. So services that we're used to being provided for, that's covered by the council tax and the grant that we get from the government, it's changing, it is changing. So we're going to be using the voluntary sector more and more. And services that, that you've been used to getting, which you think are free, but comes from general taxation, that's where the money comes from. General taxation, council tax, business tax. No, I want to finish on this.
Well,
yeah.
If you could.
But what I'm trying to answer the question so the audience understands the reasons why the council are going down particular lines. Well, and it all comes down to lack of money. But while I'll finish on this, Chair, if you'll allow me to, the council is changing. So services that you've been used to and have been free at point of use will either go completely or you'll have to be charged. So you've got to understand that. And it's the thing, I'll bring it up, the car parking charge. I can understand how people are against
it. Mike, I'd like to get some more questions in between your answers. If that's at all
okay. Alright, Chair, so I'll finish there. But don't forget the council.
Very interesting. Let's have a few more questions. People are going around again, but the gentleman over here.
I don't wish to pour more horrible news to the council, but we're desperately short of police or old people. Nursing homes we're desperately short of. We're bed blocking our hospitals to such a degree that it's a national disgrace. And what are you doing about it? You are my representative. I want to know what you put in place. I don't want to hear about £600,000 for a golf course where we've got people wanting a bed.
Absolutely, and I think I offered at the council, I think on the 15th of December, there was an issue about contacting the government to raise the issue of social care funding in Wirral. And again, in a non-political way, we were prepared to support that resolution because we believe that we needed to let the government know the issues that Wirral is facing on social care. Although I did point out that maybe it could be done in a slightly different way, and we might get better results normally. But in terms of the fundamental issue around cash, I offered to support the resolution but asked for all parties to sign a joint letter to go. That was the 15th of December. As of yet, I have not been approached by the leader of the council with any letter that he would want me to sign or send or to look at and agree. So that hasn't been done, notwithstanding we agreed it before December. I had a meeting with Sabin Javid, who's the Secretary of State for Communities and Local Government, the person who looks after the money that comes to the local authority. Because I had been invited by him to a meeting, to meet him at the to look at the £8 million investment at Wirral Met College that the government had done. I spoke to the Chief Executive's office and said, look, I'm meeting the Secretary of State for CLG. Have we got any particular lines you'd like me to push or any ask you'd like me to make of the Secretary of State? Is there anything I should be saying? And the message I got back was, tell him that Wirral Met College is, it's a really nice building. Yeah. So, in terms of what am I doing and what are members of my group doing, we're doing what we can, but actually it appears as though people are interested in engaging with us in those terms. So we'll do what we can, but I will also make the point, so I'll have a long answer now because I think that Mike's had a long answer, and decided to send this political. I will do a said, that is not the answer. Try looking at your Wirral view that nobody gets but costs us £271,000 first. Try and look at some of the other pet schemes that seem to get funded before you start putting parks at risk, kids' health at risk, and Wirral businesses at risk. This council is supposed to have 2020 pledges. They can't even join those up properly. So let's just have a bit of strength about it. I hope we can
respond to that, Chair. No, I hope you will allow me to respond to that.
I'm responding to you, Mike. Chair. You decided to go this way. The gentleman here has a question.
This is an audience question. It's coming all from you lot. I thought we were supposed to...
Hang on. Excuse me. Somebody's trying to ask a question.
10 minutes here talking. So you're the chair. You're not supposed to do that.
And you should be quiet whilst you ask a question.
I'm a member of the audience. I'll have your own
Can I speak now?
Yes, please.
The question I want to ask is already being partly answered by Councillor Elderton, and it's regarding the fire station in Southall Massey, an area where I live. Now, the planning has already been, it's gone through the process, it's had consultations, it's had meetings, it's they've had a survey, and it's gone to planning and was rejected. Now, I do know that it's come back in another form, for planning permission. Now, the people down in Sullivan Massey where I live, and a lot of other people I know, don't want this fire station. It's in a very bad place. It's in green belts, as Councillor Elderton said, and also the issue of the lanes, it's very, very dangerous. So we would like assurances, the people of Sullivan Massey, that when it comes back to planning again, in whatever form the planning may be altered or whatever, that it will be turned down again, because we really don't want it. Thank you.
Okay, I think as Councillor Elderton described, we have to judge everything on the merits. But David, do you want to just talk about the process that's ongoing at the moment?
Just before that, can I just come back to the general about the libraries?
Yeah, of course.
I think it is right that we brought in a specialist national consultant to look at a number of things, libraries, leisure centres, parks, the galleries. And what we've done is, their report is awaited. We haven't got the outcome of their report. The one thing I would say, as somebody who's been here a while, we have stressed to them some recent developments, particularly since the last library review several years ago. And one of them is the different landscape in terms of volunteers and groups having an increased role in running libraries. And the other thing we're carrying on with, we haven't stopped doing other things because they're here and they're going to produce a report. So, for example, we work with the police, and the police now occupy space in three libraries, and we're trying to do that with one of them. And also other organisations, there's a national initiative called the One Public Estate, where more services join up and use buildings. So we're still doing all those things, and we're awaiting the outcome of that report. In terms of the fire station, the applicant, you're right, made an application, and it was turned down by the planning committee, and the fire services, the applicant, then have a choice. They can either accept that decision and walk away, or they can submit a revised scheme, because the scheme was turned down for a particular reason, to do with neighbourhood amenity, I think it was, or they can appeal the decision. And the fire service are in the process. I think they've now decided to resubmit the application, and that will come back to the planning committee. And as you heard Councillor Elderton describe earlier, that is a separate function within the council.
I just add, they're also appealing it to the planning inspector at the same time.
Do you want to just say that?
But also, I'm told by my friend who comes to all our meetings that they're also, the Capital Fire Service are also appealing the decision as well at the same time to the National Planning Inspector.
Thank you, John. Any more questions? Yes, the gentleman in the blue top.
Going to have next to no effect. We've complained particularly on the grounds of Mr. Sean Brady, who deals with trees, he spoke at the opposite, to put it politely, the opposite of the truth by saying the law on ancient light of 1832 is no longer relevant. But Margaret Greenwood, the MP, has confirmed through Parliament that it is still relevant. And we've told him this. He's been on, at least two weeks ago, he's been on to the legal department in the council, and they have failed to respond to him. So he's, all I'm getting is, oh, we know nothing about it. Now, there's houses that, particularly when the leaves are on the trees, they, in daytime, they have to have the lights on so that they can see in the house. That's how bad it is. Now, we need these trees. Some of them will have to come out to give the light in, and the rest will need drastically pruning back. But to be told to think excuses like the Act of Parliament is no longer relevant when it is, it is not the proper way to do things.
Okay. Thank you for that. Stuart, I think, does Sean work in your...
I'll take the gentleman's details and we'll do
okay. All right. And we've got a note. Stuart said he'll take your details, and Stuart's the cabinet member that oversees Sean and so on. And hopefully we can report back at the next meeting to see that what's going to happen. Yeah? Is that okay? Good. Conscious we are getting very close to the witching hour. Are there any more questions? My sister, Angela.
Just a suggestion.
Good.
Sorry.
When I report on meetings in local city council, they have pal and typist typing what people are saying, and it's on a big screen, which helps people with hearing difficulties. So that's just a suggestion.
All right, okay.
Good idea, thank you. We'll look into that.
Could I just say on the microphone thing, and it is a very valid point. I think what we should do as councillors here who sit on this table is lobby, and we go on about a lack of money, but I think what we really do, and there's a problem in Welsh and town hall with the microphone system and committee room. I think what we should do is lobby, so we've got a wireless system and we don't want to stop moving around the constituency. But I think what we should do now, in view of the fact that this has been going on for years, we should invest, as a council, we should invest in a microphone system that when we come to these venues, at least everyone can hear what we're all saying. So we'll lobby for that back in the town hall, I think across parties as well.
Well,
thank you, Chair.
It's great to see peace breaking out, and that we might have a few more in order to utilise. So, thank you for that, Mike. I'm going to move on because we are getting close to the witching hour. So, next item is, I think, community representative update.
The committee is made up of both councillors, and we do have opportunities for community representatives to join. Jackie has kindly been the Hoylake and Mells representative for some time. We have had an open process where people apply for that, and it's an open process. If anyone's interested in the wards where there are vacancies, please do get in touch with Helen and I. We're pleased to say we've got a nomination for a community representative for West Kirby and Thurston, who's with us, Alicia. So we'd like to propose to the committee that Alicia Butler-Ward is formally adopted as the representative for West Kirby and Thurston for the remainder of the municipal year.
Excellent. Is that agreed? Lovely. Thank you very much.
Feel free to join us, Alicia, for the remainder of the year.
Okay. But thank you. It's very... I think it's these events, but there's also lots of stuff that we do in terms of us panels and antisocial behaviour and so on and so forth. So thank you for those community spirits and people who are prepared to get involved. We've got the community representative updates. Jackie, do you?
I did say my bit before about the parking. And one of the comments that was passed was that Hoylake and West Kirby particularly now are made up of what they call niche businesses. People do travel all over, and that will be seen in our petition, that there are signatures from out of the district. And the new petition will actually ask people, will they stop coming to the area if they have to pay to park? And that will be an interesting answer when we get that far. So we are still niche businesses. Hoylake and Mells, I have to say, have a very high percentage of shops that are working extremely well, working very hard, finding it difficult at times, but with online they're able to expand their businesses. I was amused, and I love the idea because I know so many of you are environmentalists, that the latest niche in the Hoylake area is a hedgehog sanctuary. Now, if any of you would like to support hedgehogs and you find a hedgehog, if you contact the Animal Sanctuary charity shops, they will head you to the Car Lane estate at the back of Caldy Signs, where when I was talking to them yesterday, they had 8 hedgehogs. And they're having a fundraising coffee morning at Melrose Hall to raise money for the project, which of course is a charity. After 5 years of planning the Hoylake neighbourhood plan, we are now in business. It'll be interesting to see how it progresses over the next 3 years. Every 5 years, and because it took so long and we thought we'd have finished in 2015 and we didn't, every 5 years it has to be revisited and re-updated, and that will be done by a forum and by a management committee who will keep it up to date. And I have put with our petition what from the Hoylake Development Plan they have produced as a document with planning and everything else to show why this should not happen for the parking charges. In Hoylake and Mells particularly, we have about 15 independent community groups who all work on their own to do their particular job. Most of them were set up as groups when we had a particular issue over the past 30 years. A lot of them work out of the back kitchen, don't have a lot of money, are always very grateful for the money they get from the Wirral West community funds or the your Wirral or wherever else they can get money from. And we all work together, we network together, we pass information on. I sent 3 emails today to groups that I received that won't help me, but I thought would help other people. And it would be lovely if all the wards in this constituency were able to do the same thing. I know Breesby, Frankby, Irby do. I hope that the other wards can do the same, because that's the way forward. What does worry us in Hoylake is, if all these things become volunteers, where are we? How are we going to manage to live? Because we'll all be working from 6 in the morning till midnight to do all the volunteer jobs we're expected to do. Why in Hoylake Library we did not follow Breesby and Irby was because we could not get an answer from the council as to whether, if we became volunteers, did a good job in the library, and we are aware that we're making people out of work, but would we then end up as asset management, where we would be expected not only to do the library, but to pay for the rent, to pay for the lights, to pay for everything else, which has happened with the community centres and looks as though it's going to happen to other things as well. And that was the reason why we were not prepared to become volunteers yet. And I hope that the local authority on behalf of our ward will take on board what we do and listen to the volunteers. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much. Stuart.
Thanks, Chair. I was surprised they didn't get the opportunity to answer the question about the car parking charges, you know, when people are asking questions of what the questions are. I just want to give some assurance to the audience that, you know, the car parking charge proposals that you will read about were all officer proposals. No decisions being made. Before any decisions were going to be made, you know, obviously we're going to take out all petitions, all representations, you know, people have made, so I just want to give that assurance.
Well, okay, I think the important thing for me, because I saw the report and I saw Phil Davis' picture on the front of it and his quote underneath it about it, but I think all anyone's asking for is that the administration listens to this depth and strength and feeling of the public and the impact it's going to have, and actually withdraw those particular proposals. But we've asked for a special council, so we'll be able to debate it there. But you're more than welcome to answer the question, Stuart, any time, as you know. Okay, so that's community. I think it would be a bit unfair for us, Alicia, to give a report at the very first meeting. But charging them to come when we're trying to build up
£28 million that that's going to bring in revenue, but not look to the detriment that it's going to cause to that local area. That's my only concern.
I mean, well said. And passionate community rep who brings together those groups, I'm sure it's going to be incredibly welcome and bring good common sense to our deliberation. So thank you very much for that. I think that, was there any other? Yes, sorry. Gosh, how could I forgot that? Yeah, if you would, thank you.
Last item is my regular progress and budget report. I highlighted a few actually of the things that we've been doing recently in my presentation, so I won't cover that in the report, but I am asking the committee for something specific, which is in relation to the environmental budget that we've had in place for some time, but we've been discussing how best to utilise that, and some two recommendations that we use 5,000 of that for a small grants programme, as set out in the recommendation. That the remainder that we do some days of action in local communities, work with groups, work with all the different agencies to have some sort of focus clean on days. So I'm hoping that the committee will support that, and then we can get on and do the job of taking that forward.
Again, I'm sure we've all read the report and seen the excellent work you've been doing. Was he content to agree those recommendations?
Agreed.
Thank you very much. I think we've moved the agenda around a bit. I think we're now on any other business. And I wasn't notified of any other business. Is there anything particular? In that case, can I thank everyone for their attendance. And the next meeting we have here is 27th of April.
Yes.
Is that right?
And that sets the chat.
No, this is never